And welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss a classification of organic compounds. How organic compounds are classified into various types. So first type is on the basis of a functional group. Now what is this functional group? Functional group is a group of atoms or atom that decide the chemical behavior of organic compound, that decide the chemical properties of organic compounds. We have studied various functional group in class 10th also. For example, we have if OH group is present, that is alcohol. If CHO group is there, that is aldehyde. If NH2 group is there, that is amine. If COOH group is present, that is carboxylic acid. If any halogen there, that is halide. So according to functional groups, organic compounds are classified, and by this classification we obtain a homologous series of different functional groups. By this classification we obtain homologous series of different functional groups, and two consecutive members of a homologous series are called homologies. Let us create a homologous series for alcohol. We have three consecutive members of a alcohol series, homologous series of alcohol. The consecutive members of a homologous series are called homologies. One thing to be noted here, the homologies must have a different molecular formula. But if they have same molecular formula, then they are not called homologies, they are called isomers. These three carbon containing alcohol can be represented in this way. This is again alcohol of three carbons, but now both these have same molecular formula. Now they are not called homologous, they must be called isomers. Homologies must have a different molecular formula, but if they have same molecular formula of any organic compound, then they are called isomers. So that is the first classification according to the functional group, and by functional group we obtain a homologous series, and the members of homologous series are called homologies. Next thing is according to classification according to name of scientist. Some organic compounds are known with the discovery of their scientist. For example, RMGX, alkyl magnesium halide, that is known as Grignard reagent. It is the most versatile compound of organic chemistry. Dialkyl zinc, that is known as Franklin reagent. एंड वी हैव मैनी मोर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स विच वर डिस्कवर्ड बाई साइंटिस्ट एंड दे वर नोन विद दियर साइंटिस्ट नेम. दिस इज क्लासिफिकेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू नेम ऑफ अ साइंटिस्ट. थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन इज थर्ड इज अकॉर्डिंग टू सोर्स ऑफ कंपाउंड. सम ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड आर नोन विद दियर सोर्स नेम बाई विच दे आर बाई विच दे वर ऑब्टेन्ड. सम ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड वर फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव CH4 is known as methane or marsh gas. Why? Because it is obtained in marshy areas. Second, methyl alcohol or methanol is known as wood spirit obtained from wood. Next is formic acid HCOH. We obtain it from red ants. Next is acetic acid. We obtained it from vinegar. So this classification is based on the source of compound from where they were first extracted or isolated. Even we have lactic acid obtained from curd. So this classification is according to the source of a compound. Next is according to the structure of compounds. Fourth classification is according to structure of compounds, and maximum common names were given according to this classification. So first is a common name of saturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons are known as alkane, where alk represents the number of carbon atoms. Alk represents the number of carbon atoms. And if we have one carbon, then root word is alk word is meth. If we have two carbon, we have two carbon, then root word is alk word is eth. Three carbon prop. C4 is but. C5 pent. C6 is hex. C7 hept. C8 oct. C9 none, and C10 is dec, followed by the suffix ane. So we have saturated hydrocarbons: methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, and decane. So this is the common name of saturated hydrocarbons. They all are represented with the common formula, general formula.
CnH2n plus 2, where n is the number of carbon atoms. For example, so we can make a list of saturated hydrocarbons by adding carbons, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, and so on. So if there are different molecular formulas, sorry, same molecular formula but different structures, then compound are called isomers, and then we use term N-iso and neo. If saturated hydrocarbon chain is straight, then we use N. For example, we have butane, it may be written as N-butane. We use the term iso when there is a single branch at a second position. Second carbon contains one substituent group or one branch. One methyl group at a second carbon from any side. So this N-butane can be represented as there is a single branch at a second carbon, second position. So now this is a isobutane. And next is neo. If there are double branch at second position, then we use the term neo. This is a 5 carbon containing saturated hydrocarbon pentane, but we can see there are 2 branches at second positions, 2 methyl groups at a second position, so it is now neopentane. So butane has 2 isomers, N-butane and isobutane, but for pentane 3 isomers are possible, 3 chain isomers are possible, N-pentane, isopentane and neopentane, but there are 2 exceptional cases for isooctane and isoheptane. This is 8 carbon containing saturated hydrocarbon octane, but this is exceptionally called isooctane. There is a case of a single branch as well as a double branch, so exceptionally it is called isooctane. Second example is isoheptane. Again, it is a mix-up of iso and neo, but it is called isoheptane, 7 carbon containing saturated hydrocarbon. And isoheptane is also known as a triptane. So this is the common name for saturated hydrocarbons. But we have unsaturated hydrocarbon like alkene and alkyne. So now we are going to discuss for alkene and alkyne. Saturated hydrocarbon, unsaturated hydrocarbon is alkene, but the common name of alkene is alkylene. Common name is alkylene. This is two carbon containing unsaturated hydrocarbon alkene, but its common name will be ethylene. Three carbon containing alkene, propylene. Four carbon containing alkene, butylene. Even we can give the number to the carbon containing double bond. Instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, in common names we use alpha, beta, gamma, delta. So this is alpha, so this is alpha butylene. If double bond is to next position, so we don't use the numbers here, we use the symbols alpha, beta, gamma in a common nomenclature. In IUPAC we use the number 1, 2, 3. So now here we use symbols alpha butylene and beta butylene. Next is for alkyne, common names of unsaturated hydrocarbon alkyne. The first member of alkyne is known as acetylene, and the next members, higher members of alkyne series are the name given with respect to acetylene, derivative of acetylene. For example, we have now this is acetylene. Instead of one hydrogen we have methyl group, so this is methyl acetylene. Now acetylene format is this. Now we have two branches, so it is dimethyl acetylene. If we have different substituent groups, then we use them alphabetically. This is acetylene, this group is ethyl, this is methyl. E comes first, then M. So this is ethyl, methyl, acetylene. Right. So this is a common name for unsaturated hydrocarbons. In next segment, we will do the common nomenclature of saturated radicals or hydrocarbons derivatives of hydrocarbons. Thanks for watching.